Hi, I'm Daria Fasun with a new product update from Time & Pixels. We're delighted to share that OmniScope now features a powerful new video scope option, Twin Peaks Scope. Twin Peaks features a specialized diamond-shaped display, commonly found in television production, to ensure accurate color correction and compliance with broadcast standards. The scope trace visualizes the relative levels of red, green, and blue channels, offering a clear readout of color distribution and balance. In addition to channel visualization, these displays highlight legal color gamut boundaries in both RGB and YCbCr color spaces. By overlaying diamond-shaped plots, they reveal areas where color signals exceed broadcast standards, enabling colorists to identify and correct gamut errors quickly and adhere to legal broadcast requirements. To demonstrate how the Twin Peaks scope might be used in practice, we've invited guest colorist Chad Smith from Massive Clouds to talk about how he uses this tool.
Hey, Chad Smith, a colorist here in New York's Hudson Valley, and I've been using a diamond hardware scope for many years. I really like it, so I'm very excited to see that functionality is now part of OmniScope. Let's take a look.
I'm in my studio running DaVinci Resolve, and I use OmniScope for most signal monitoring. However, I still regularly use a hardware scope for specific color tasks. I personally find the scope really useful, but the display might be a little daunting for new users. You can basically think of Twin Peaks as presenting the RGB color cube from two different angles, dead on the corner. This scope is valuable to me as it provides new perspective on the image I'm working on. Here in the middle is the black point, and at the top and bottom are the white points. When an image is black and white, you will see a simple straight line referencing the luma value of your image. When looking at a color image, the scope comes to life. In the top diamond, green is on the left and blue is on the right. In the bottom diamond, green is also on the left and the red values are on the right. So red in the shadows, for instance, will present this way. Or if your highlights are skewing green or blue, you can see this in the top trace on the upper diamond. I work on a lot of documentary films and I like to use the diamond scope when I need just a little something special. In this shot, I can play around to get an idea. For example, I might push green into the gamma or subtract red from the blue channel. However, I find the most efficient way to really see what's going on is to pull up the diamond scope. If you think of this as the same as the curves tool, I can select the lows in the green channel and then pull them into a more straight line to correct the image. It's all about perspective. I may set up my waveform for RGB or zoom into my vector scopes 200%. But if I want to visualize in another way, then the Twin Peaks are really useful. For another example, I've created a simple ramp. In the Twin Peaks, you can see that this is showing straight line on both diamond sections. Again, black is in the center, and the whites are on the top and tail of the displays. Now, if I will change the color temperature, and as we warm it up, the trace curves towards the red side of this diamond. Diamond scopes are also a great way to check blacks and highlights. If your blacks sit down into the black point, then you're good. If not, try working with the log wheels just to tighten the reds in the shadows, or really whatever your particular shot needs to come correct.
I hope you found this useful. Using a diamond scope is almost like learning a different language. It's a different way to visualize, and I find that after a while it becomes really intuitive. But like most things in color, it's a taste thing. You don't have to use the Twin Peaks, but I'm glad it's there. Option 9 in my keyboard, and there it is. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Chad. To learn more about OmniScope, please visit timeandpixels.com. And for more video training on color correction topics, please click the button below to subscribe to our channel.